welcome back to the channel. If you've been watching this channel for any time at all, you know two things. One is every time I come out to make a video, there's an airplane going over. There's one right there. I don't know if you can hear it or not. And the other thing is that we're moving into my dad's house and we'll be leaving our big property here in Jupiter Farms behind. So before I go, I thought I'd make a few more videos for you. I've already made a tour of the yard. You can see that right here. I've done other videos on Mingarelias and Bromeliads and Sago. I'm working on one now on Sagos. So before I left, I thought I'd come talk to you about Bocarnia, or what are commonly called ponytail palms, although they are not palms at all. Here's one right here. Kind of a modest size when I'm shaking it because it's kind of hard to see all these fronds. This is Bocarnia recurvata, which means that the fronds recurve. It's also called Guatemalensis. This species is identified by the big bulb at the bottom that stores water, but there's also another variety that doesn't have the bulb. It has a straight trunk. I used to have a very tall one of those, but I moved to Gainesville, Florida with it, and it got killed in the frost of 79 or something like that. But anyway, this is a Bocarnia. They are desert plants from Mexico and Guatemala. They're part of the lily family, the big genus or family's Liliaceae. And plants are identified by which family they're in by their flowers and the types of flowers. All of the lily families, which you would commonly know as like yucca, soft tip yucca, and the spiny tip yucca called Spanish bayonets, you see over at the beach here a lot. Here comes a squirrel. I guess he wants to listen in on what's going on. They all flower the same way. They have big plumes that come up on the top. Big plumes of white flowers that come up in the top. And then they usually will sprout and branch off into different heads after they flower. This is called a head. If you watch some of the other videos on YouTube, you'll see little tiny house plants, but this is what they can look like in South Florida. Now, when I worked in the nursery business back in the mid-70s in Miami, we used to buy plants that people had brought from the desert in Mexico, but there was a prohibition on taking plants more than a certain height, 2 or 3 feet. So they would dig up these small ones and chop them off, and we would buy the bottom with the bulb. They would sprout multiple heads, and that's kind of like what you're seeing on these other YouTube channels. But this is the real deal. The fronds die and are very easily pulled off like that. Kind of snap them. The plants, they like really, really bright sun, but like all plants or people, don't go from shade to full sun or they'll sunburn. But once you get them acclimated, they can take a lot of sun and prefer. This one is out in nearly full sun all day, and you can see this is a really, really good example of how the head should look. As far as water, they store water in the bottom, so do not water them much at all. You know, very, very infrequently. Treat them like almost like a cactus. Otherwise, they're very easy to grow. They don't have any pest. You probably won't propagate it. Being a lily, they could be propagated from cuttings, but you probably wouldn't do that. You probably buy a small house plant, or if you live down here, you might find one at an outdoor nursery. If you live in what's called Zone 10 or South Florida, you might find one in an outdoor nursery. Give it plenty of room. This one has been here, I don't know, a couple of years. This was another one of my famous trash pile finds that I dragged home a few years ago and put it in the ground. So if you plant it, it'll add a nice vertical element to your tropical yard, but don't put it anywhere where you're going to have to cut the top off it. Now, people usually do that with Italian cypress and some of these tall, skinny palms. They put them under eaves, and then they eventually have to take them out. There's a car dealership in town that was all remodeled, and they came and they put these Tychosperma palms right under the eaves. You know, within 2 or 3 years, they're going to have them all removed. So, try and try and use it as an accent plant for a vertical element, and you should be rewarded with many, many years of trouble-free enjoyment. Thanks a lot for watching, and stay tuned. I'm going to have some more videos for you before I move. If you enjoy this video, you might consider subscribing so you don't miss other ones. And if you have the time to give me a thumbs up, I really appreciate it. Till the next video, have a great afternoon.